又来到职场英语系列。
That's right. Today we're talking about 7 different idioms that you can use in the workplace to sound more awesome.
首先第一个就是跟奶油有关 ，butter someone up.
That's right. Just like this, you take it.
其实没有这样，美国人不吃人肉，不是。Anyway,
butter someone up actually just means that you are giving someone lots of compliments and being nice to them so that you can get something from them, some kind of opportunity or some kind of special treatment.
Like a raise or a promotion or a vacation.
Exactly. If you butter someone up, it's not necessarily negative, but it always means that you're kind of trying to get something from somebody.
Let's give them an example.然后我们来举个例子，比方说，哎，你看那个同事又在拍老板马屁了。
Exactly. Hey, Ralph is totally trying to butter up the boss so he can get a promotion. Or, Larry has been buttering up the boss for months, so he was surprised when he didn't get the promotion.
拍马屁也没用。好，第二个呢，就是你可能在组别里面，或者是有一群人一起做 project， 你常会听到 make headway。
This idiom it probably started with the Navy because originally headway means the forward motion of a boat.
Okay.
But when we use it as an idiom, to make headway just means to make progress towards a particular goal or to finish a particular project.
所以如果真的过年要到了，要跟同事说，哎，我们要赶快赶进度，要怎么跟他说呢
？You could say, "Hey, we really need to make headway on this project before the new year, or we're not going to finish it in time."
Okay, 第三个呢，跟绳子有关 ，learn the ropes or
show someone the ropes.
所以意思是什么
？Okay, so this idiom also has its roots in sailing culture because when you're on a boat, it involves a lot of ropes and knots. So when you're trying to learn how to tie knots and use the ropes of a boat, you have to put in a lot of effort. There's a lot of rope, right? There's a lot to learn.
你在做香肠。
So anyway, but if you're learning the ropes, it originally would mean that you were a young sailor learning how to tie the knots and pull the ropes to raise the sails. It has gone on to mean that you are any person in a new position who was learningthe essentials and the basics of that profession.
第四个 a solid grasp on something.
Yes, a solid grasp.
Or of something.
A solid grasp.
Okay, so if you have a solid grasp of or on something, it means that you have a good understanding of what it is, how it works, or how to do it.
这个尤其是在面试的时候很常听到，像是面试官会说 Do you have a solid grasp on anything? 你可能说 I have a solid grasp on Premiere or Adobe, Excel, Word.
Yes, this is a good one to know if you're writing your resume as well. When you're writing out your skills, you can say I have a solid grasp on how to code programs using Python and HTML. Right? It sounds like, oh, this guy knows what he's doing. It doesn't mean you've mastered it.But it means that you can do it if you're asked to.
All right, 第五个 up to one's neck, up to one's ears, up to one's eyes. 这跟台湾人常会讲说，哦，我已经满到这边了。如果你比较矮一点，这边 ，okay.
That's right. Yeah. Now, if you are up to your ears, eyes, neck, or whatever in work or homework or something else, then it just means that you have more.Work, you have more things to do than you can actually do. Like, you have more work than you can handle.
All right, 例如说 I have to leave early. Could you cover me for this project?
Ah, sorry, man. I am up to my neck in emails from the new client. I can't help you this time.
All right, 第六个 have a lot on one's plate. 其实跟刚刚第五个有点类似，就是很多东西已经装不下了。
To have a lot on one's plate does not mean that you have all the things you want to eat at an all-you-can-eat buffet. It means that you have too many tasks and or responsibilities. This idiom can also refer to different responsibilities that you have. So maybe you are the video director at your job and you're also playing the piano at church and then you also have some other responsibilities at work. For example, if I said to David, hey, David, do you want to take on that new client I met at the expo?
No, sorry. I have too much on my plate already. 最后一个 number 7, 多走一里路英文就是 go the extra mile.
That's right. Now, this idiom is great. It actually has its origins from the Bible, from something that Jesus said in his very famous Sermon on the Mount. And when he said it, it was just all about doing more than you're expected, giving more love than you're expected to, often to a stranger.
有些人会自我要求多走一里路，或者是要求别人多走一里路。
Right. Now, if someone makes you go the extra mile, then it's not really going the extra mile. You can only really go the extra mile if you have decided that you want to give more than was asked of you. For example, James stayed late for a whole week to help me find new clients. What a nice person.
Yeah, that sounds like Jane. She always goes the extra mile for her coworkers.
Boom. Way to go, Jane.
Alright, 还有一种用法就是你也可以用鼓励的方式，你可以鼓励别人。For example, I can never satisfy my professor.
Well, maybe you should try just going the extra mile to really set yourself apart from the other students. 以上就是我们今天的好想讲英文。
除了我们今天教的这七个以外，我们还有好几十个不同的用语。如果大家喜欢的话，我们就继续做。或者如果你想要特别知道哪几个不同的话，你也可以在下面告诉我们。
That's right. Smash that like button, hit subscribe, ring the little bell.
Go the extra mile.
Tell your friends, tell your family.Go butter up your boss and get that promotion before the new year. Bah! Show them the ropes. And we'll show you the ropes.